obviously. The group reunited for one final dinner party.
In the letter, it just basically said, I wish I'd have got down on my knees and terrorised your bumhole.
Discovering which marriages had stood the test of time.
Ross lives with me now.
But for some, it was an emotional reunion.
I put my life on the line for you.
I think I'm quite numb.
Oh, I just need 5 minutes.
He didn't want me. He just killed me.
Whilst gossip amongst the group...
A comment that was made about my daughter from yourselves. God help her, she turns out like a mother.
Reignited old tensions.
You're all screaming at me, yes!
Who the are you talking to? Oh, I'm fuming.
And as happy couples had cause for celebration...
I want loads of kids.
Little Nathan Juniors. Whoa!
It was familiar frustrations between Polly and Adam.
Why are you bitching about someone that doesn't want you?
Because I want to.
We had sex 3 times for 10 weeks.
That erupted into the biggest showdown of the night.
You!
Tonight.
Welcome, everyone, to the final commitment ceremony.
The couples come face to face with the experts.
I've really got me that.
For some, it's a celebration.
He tells me he loves me. I'm loving it.
We've got something really special.
We don't.
Yeah.
While animosity brews for others.
I feel like there was a real sort of pack mentality.
Talk about my children. I'm coming to war.
Failed marriages go under the microscope.
Emma deserved a husband who could give her what she was looking for, and that's on me.
Felt like Ryan was trying to keep me under his thumb.
You specifically used the term, I want to terrorise your butthole.
Oh, God, so...
I don't think I've done anything wrong.
Oh, come on, Adam.
Are you taking the piss out of me?
And the breakdown of their marriage...
How much did it mean to Kieran? Because it meant the absolute world to me.
To have her sit and think that I don't care about her, shit.
Raises questions for Kieran and Christina.
Why are you not together? Welcome, everyone, to the final commitment ceremony. And the last gathering of what I'm sure you can all agree has been an unforgettable experience.
Well, there is clearly a lot to discuss from last night's dinner party. But tonight is also about celebrating the good times and learning from the bad. But before we dig in, let's remind ourselves of where this incredible journey began.
No, stop.
Oh, my God.
Marriage is forever. This is one of the biggest things I've ever done in my life.
It'll be everything to me, too. Start a new life with someone who I adore.
I'm ready to have that missing piece of the puzzle, love, a partner, and build a life together.
The right person is definitely out there.
I'm risking everything for love.
I never in a million years imagined I was going to be marrying a stranger.
I am looking for my knight in shining armour.
I'm ready to meet the love of my life.
I'm so close to giving up on love, but I'm willing to give it one last shot.
Shannon.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. Are you okay?
Yeah, not bad.
Oh, I'm happy!
Pleasure's all mine.
Stephen. You look so
nice to meet you.
I'm Kitisha.
St. Kitts?
Yes.
Are you a true Caribbean?
Yes, I am.
I promise to bring spontaneity, a sense of adventure, and an excellent loaf of bread.
Today, I say I do, but to me, that means I will. I will take your hand and stand by your side for the good and bad.
I might be deaf, but I will always hear you. Oh! Hugo!
Oh, my God! Oh, my God!
So this is Hugo.
I love him so much.
It is time for you to share your very first kiss. I'm so happy.
She's perfect.
Everything happens for a reason.
I genuinely feel like it couldn't have got any better.
This is everything I've ever dreamed of.
Aww.
Love is wild.
Oh,
yeah.
You okay?
Lots of emotion in the room. Holly, it's really hit you.
Surprisingly, it was seeing me and Alex looking happy.
Yeah.
It just looked like the perfect image. It really got me that.
Charlie, what's coming up for you there watching that, my love?
I'm still living that moment, even today, where I remember, like, that initial feeling that I had for Eve. But I guess just seeing that today has kind of made me realise maybe I'm not over it as much as I thought I was.
The grieving process has no cap. So remember that and allow yourself that. Sadly, the relationship didn't work as we had all planned. Thank you for showing up as your full self. We can't wait to see what the future holds for you.
Yes.
Thank you.
Awesome. Obviously, Rochelle is not here. How are you feeling about, you know, your reflection on this relationship and where it's brought you to today?
I came in with the intention to find a wife, walk away with a wife. Obviously, the relationship didn't really go the way that, you know, I wanted it to go. I definitely underestimated the experiment because I didn't realize it was going to be like that intense. I was actually looking forward to seeing her, believe it or not. So I wish she was here, but I hope she's well.
Well, we're sorry that things didn't work out the way that you wanted to, but we also noted that there was a bit of a spark between you and Hannah.
Yes. There was definitely that spark.
Mm-hmm.
I can't lie. We just felt like there wasn't enough for us to be like, right, okay, let's make this work.
For me, the way that Orson treated me and spoke to me and the respect that he showed me was huge, considering what I had to deal with. I don't think we just kissed for the sake of it. It was very much like, let's see if this is a thing. Mm-hmm. I do think we could have a really nice friendship after this. Yeah, I've got a lot of time for him and he's a really good guy.
Well, thank you, Orson. We have loved having you as part of this experiment. Thank you.
Okay, first up to the couch, we have
Amy and Luke. Woo!
Hey guys.
Hello.
Hello. Hello, good to see you. Welcome back.
Nice to see you.
Thank you. Okay, so before we delve into your journey and where you are right now, should we take a quick look at your final vows?
Magical.
Let's do it.
Amy, with all our highs, there have been many lows. I feel responsible for causing many of these lows. We have shared the most special moments together, Amy, and I do not want to give up. Our future starts now.
Luke, you and my Prince Charming stood at the altar. You showed me you were a gentleman, and it gave me a glimpse of what could be.
There has never been a dull day with you. I came into this experiment knowing exactly what I wanted, and I'm leaving this experiment knowing exactly what I do not want. This marriage is done. Dead. Deceased. I stand here in front of you today, wearing black to mourn its death. R.I.P.
Oh, that was fucking shit. Savage.
Wow.
That was brutal.
That was quite an exit. How do you feel watching it back?
Awful. I feel like I had so much, like, built up anger and upset. Felt like I needed to get it off my chest. I felt better after I did it, but watching it back, it might have been a little bit savage.
And Luke, how was that experience for you?
It was very sad. I was sad that I was the one to make her feel that way.
So after the final vows, what has happened since then?
You sent me like a birthday gift, didn't you? With a letter in it.
Would you say that there's a part of you that's holding out hope that maybe Amy might change her mind?
Of course. I'll always have a fond memory of the stuff we've done. I know how I felt. I know how you made me feel, Amy, when we went on the honeymoon. It was such a poignant moment that uplifted me. You gave me confidence like no other.
Amy, you look irritated.
It just baffles me like this, because obviously the letter went quite into depth about how much he missed me and he's always thinking about me, referring to me as his wife, and nice, rude comment at the end of it.
A rude comment?
It said, no regrets, actually just one. I wish I'd have got down on my knees when you were cooking in the kitchen and terrorised your bumhole.
Oh, God, son.
OK. I do remember us having this conversation about flirting and about what's a turn on and what's a turn off. I suppose I'm curious what your thoughts were around terrorising the bumhole. I mean, I know we're all laughing about this, but I'm not saying this with any kind of judgment. In relationships, we have our own codes of conversation, we have our own banter and a bit of flirting, and it sounds like this is something that maybe took place privately between the two
of you. No, it didn't. No, it did not.
You specifically used the term, I want to terrorize your butthole.
Yeah.
Have you ever used that term before?
I think we...
You've never said that to me before.
Yeah, but we've done it. I've showed her.
You've not done that to me. He's never done anything like that to me.
Not to your bumhole.
What? What the hell is coming out of Luke's mouth right now? My bumhole has never seen any action in its whole existence. Never mind with Luke. And I'd rather it not be spoken about again. He's never done anything like that to me.
Not to your bumhole.
What?
No, no, I'm just saying, have you ever used the term before?
Probably not.
Okay. Do you believe that could be a shocking term?
I want it to be. It's some feeling I have.
Okay, there you go. So here's someone who you've never used this term with. You know it's shocking and you drop it in a letter. Why is that?
It's a word, Paul. It's a word. I have to choose a word that reflects how I feel.
You went with terrorize.
Whatever I would do from day one, from the marriage almost, we were always misunderstood. I'm a bit quirky. I'm a non-conformer, and that's what I've learned. And I'm going to stop trying to conform.
And there's something powerful in that. But can I just give you some advice around relationships?
Yes, please.
We're saying it's about reading the room.
Mm.
And what she has said consistently is that those types of language just don't do it for her.
I just wanted to let her know that I fancy the pants off you. And that's how you make me feel sexually. Oh, I'm really sorry for really wanting you, Amy. I sincerely apologize.
I just didn't understand the motive behind it after what happened at Final Vows. Like, that book was closed.
Right, OK. I think it is important also for you, Luke, to be able to acknowledge, you know, how hurt and disappointed you were. Because you had really hoped for a future with Amy.
We were always trying to please each other, but we weren't getting there. Mm. And it was a big shame, because in the end, I look at Amy and she has many qualities that I asked for. And the person walks away from me. And that's painful, because then I think to myself, then what do I do? Do I change the way I speak, or do I start thinking twice about what words I use?
I'm not saying you're a bad person. I don't know if you're saying things and meaning another thing, but there's been so many lies. The trust was just gone. And we were just, like, fighting a losing battle.
And Amy, what would you say you've learned about yourself throughout this process?
I feel like I've learned how to be very patient. I've learned to have more confidence in myself and speak how I feel. Thank you for letting me be able to do that. You've helped with that. I feel like I've grown as a person, and thank you for that as well.
Lovely. It was amazing to meet you both, and I really wish you all the very best in your future relationships.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Of course, I wish that things turned out differently. I just wish that Amy accepted me and embraced my sexualized nature. I do wish to find someone that accepts me for who I am, with my quirkiness and everything that I embody, I guess. And my letter writing as well, that's very important.
Okay, so next up to the couch, we have Nathan and Lacey.
Welcome back.
It's nice to be back.
Yeah. Do you like our outfits?
You look beautiful together. Coordinating, I love it. So, how have things been?
Do you know what? It's been better than I thought. Non-stop compliments, he tables me, loves me. Like, I'm loving it. He's good.
So it sounds like your relationship is going from strength to strength. Let's look at your final vows. That special day.
There we go. Nathan, you've opened up to me. Sorry. And I believe you were brought to me for a reason, Nath. You make me feel safe, heard, and loved. I love you.
There is so much I love about you. I love how patient you are with me and how you have grown to understand me and how I think. One second. One sec. I never get tired of spending time with you. I love you to the stars and back.
Wow. Fantastic.
What a beautiful love story.
I still feel the same as on the wedding day, you know, that buzzing, do you know what I mean?
Have you seen any kind of challenges at all? Like, what, since you've been away from the experiment?
I feel like I don't always filter my words or what I tried to say properly. Sometimes I might say something, meant something completely different, might come out right, but it can come out a little bit rude.
Yeah.
I think...
I hung up on him.
Yeah, so she can take that to heart. And
I said, I don't want to talk to you right now. I archived his chat. I didn't even see his name.
Yeah. Yeah, sometimes, yeah, that can be a bit hard.
But I only gave him 10 minutes. I didn't, I just needed a till. Think about what I was going to say, because I didn't want, because I was a bit pissed off at the time.
Yeah. And I suppose it's quite normal, isn't it? The expectation can't be that it's always lovey-dovey
all
the time.
No, yeah, we're not perfect at all.
It's definitely different. It's not every day you sit in front of someone and talk about stuff you're not good at and you struggle with. It's something that I'd probably run 100 miles away from outside. So yeah, it was definitely hard, but when I was a bit down and sad and that, Lace was always there to pull me out of it. So yeah, I'm grateful to have gone through it with her 100%.
What I've reflected on as well is in my past, when I've dated guys, they've love bombed me. And, you know, he wasn't doing that, which is normal, like, this is normal, healthy. So I'm sorry that I wanted it all. But you know what? I wouldn't change it all, because look where we are now, you know? Right. He just makes me feel confident and sexy, and I could be my goofy self. Thank you, guys, honestly. You done good.
Oh, we know.
Yeah.
And so, I know at the dinner party, there were talks of a little Nathan Junior.
Did I say that?
I'm in no rush, mind. No. Do you know what I mean? It does take... No, yeah, I'm in no rush. Yeah, you know,
but it's nice
that
we're having those conversations.
Yeah.
That we are on the same page.
Lovely. Well, we are so excited to see where this goes. I'm so excited to hear about any Nathan Juniors.
Bit hot now.
So, we've come to the end for you here in terms of this experiment. So we wish you all the very best, guys.
Thank you so much. Good job.
All right, we'd like to welcome back to the couch, Polly and Adam. Come on up.
Help.
Good to see you. There's a lot that we have to unpack, but before we really get down to business, let's think back to what happened yesterday. Things got heated between the two of you, and Polly, you have admitted that your physical outburst definitely was unacceptable.
Yeah, it was bad. I shouldn't have done it.
What you did crossed the line.
Yeah.
That was unacceptable behavior.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. Now, let's go back. I think we should take a look at the Polly and Adam journey, can we?
In an ideal world, he'd look at me and be like, oh my God.
I'm hoping to turn around at the end of the aisle and just fancy the pants off her.
You're all right. Nice to meet you.
I do fancy him, yeah.
The initial attraction's not 100% there.
She's not my usual type. I normally go with girls that I think, oh, my God, you're unreal.
On the wedding day.
Feels quite natural sharing a bed, doesn't it?
Yeah. There has been intimacy. It happened really naturally.
Thinking about it, I realised that maybe I shouldn't have done it just because I don't know where my head's at.
It's a tricky one, and obviously, she really fancies me, and I want to say it back to her, you know what I mean? But I don't want to give her the wrong idea because I don't want to hurt her.
But you're married and you've had sex.
Ooh.
Yeah.
If you could stick with your current partner or twist with another, would you stick or twist?
Twist.
Ooh.
For you to twist is bullshit.
You're not very romantic.
Here's something that I do need to work on.
Shut the fuck up.
Is it the most romantic thing someone's ever done for you?
Yeah. I do feel like there is love in the air.
3, 2.
Adam, you cheater! You're such a cheat!
Seeing she's very family orientated, it has been a nice insight into how life could potentially be. What size panties are you? I think you look sexy in these. Nan?
I don't feel like you want me in any way.
I've put you first through this whole time. You've put yourself first. Never once has it been about me.
Oh, mate.
Would any of you guys want to have sex with someone that's moaning at you all day?
Well, you did for the first 3 weeks.
We've had sex like 3 times.
You are such a fucking narcissist.
Narcissist?
You've led me on, you've fucked me about, and you've pissed me right off.
If you were emotionally mature,
You would have known what you would have wanted and not given me mixed signals when it came to intimacy. You used me to paint a narrative that you could be a good man, a good husband, but all you've really done is show that you're a good liar.
Childish, bored.
Oh, fucking, you're walking away again. You are a fucking joke. Shit.
Okay. That was a lot. Watching that back, how does that make you feel?
For me, I do feel very led on. I feel like nothing was ever really there on his part. He's just shown me that he's just not a nice person. I just feel very, very lied to.
Adam, do you believe that you were fully transparent to Polly? Were you truthful to her from the beginning?
Yeah, I was truthful from the start. I always told her everything. I gave her the heads up on everything.
Do you feel that you were kind to Polly throughout this?
Yeah, I think I treated her well, yeah.
Okay, it's important for us to spend a moment in this space because I think a common challenge that the two of you had is the sex. Adam, do you believe that the sex was leading Polly on? Do you regret having sex with Polly?
Probably on the first night, it was probably like wrong of me to do it before I kind of knew where my head was at and stuff. But I didn't regret it.
So, Polly, do you feel Adam was leading you on through the sex?
Yeah.
But Adam, was the sex just physical for you or did it mean more?
No, it was trying to like boost what was missing, you know what I mean?
But when he was saying all the stuff of like, yeah, there is a potential, I do fancy you, like, I do see a potential when we leave, is that not fucking needing someone on?
I think on this issue, question is the intention of it, right? Polly, you're saying that you feel as if the sex was happening because we are in a relationship.
Yeah.
All right, so now, Adam, it seems like what happened is that you walked in, you were physically not attracted to your wife, but you said, you know what? I'm in this experiment. I'm going to give it my all. Hmm. And part of that was, I'm going to give it my all. So where did it turn for you, Adam?
The first day we got back from homestays, she was just being like mardy and like bickering. And you kind of like bigging me up and then shutting me down.
Because you still weren't giving what I was asking for the whole way through, which was to be felt wanted by your partner.
But that is the reason I was just drained. Every other day she used to say to me like, oh, you treat me like a princess. You do so much like acts of service for me. And then 10 seconds later, she'll go, you don't do enough for me. I feel like I deserve better. Got to the point where I was like, I can't do this no more, Polly.
I hear a lot of what you're saying. But the one part I don't see is how you have zero accountability for the failure of your marriage.
Because he's 90% perfect and he's such a catch. And he can never do any wrong until he's pulled up on his behaviour, which he doesn't like, and he ducks out.
I don't think I've done anything wrong.
Oh, come on, Adam.
You're not taking accountability for your behaviour again.
What? What have I done wrong?
Oh, Adam.
Anyone?
Are you taking the piss out of me?
What have I done wrong?
Oh, Adam.
Anyone?
Are you taking the piss out of me? You still feel like you've done nothing wrong for us to be in the position that we're in?
I haven't done anything. I haven't bad-mouthed you. I haven't spoke about you. You're the one that's been ripping me in the girls' chat.
Ripping you in the girls' chat, which was sending a video that I found funny. I've tried to reach out to you multiple times, and all three times, you were so rude. You just spoke to me like shit. All you done last night was dig and dig and dig and push buttons, which unfortunately led you to be in the position that you were in. And I've never, ever been in that position with someone to feel the need to do that.
If something's said, you know what I mean, that hurts me, like, it is hard to just forget about.
Yeah. Adam, there's something that Polly said that I could see really impacted you, and that was when she called you a narcissist. Mm. Why was that such a problem for you?
I've always classed it as someone that's like just a nasty piece of work, you know what I mean?
So, you know, that's a big statement. So it just so happens, before the commitment ceremony, what I did is I went back and I looked at Adam's profile. He's not a narcissist. Could you say there are things that you could have done better?
100%. I could have done so much better.
Like?
Like how I spoke to him sometimes, how I addressed certain situations, how I spoke about him in a group setting when I was a bit irate. I'm not sitting here saying that I didn't do anything wrong. I know I did.
And I'm just curious for the group is, were there moments where you all saw something between these two?
Yeah, absolutely. Definitely. They got on like a house on fire. Yeah. Like,
there was that personality spark between them. Definitely early on, they were really tight and really strong.
Yeah.
Best relationships start as friendships, and that's what they started as.
Yes, this is great feedback because I think we all saw this. So that is my hope for the two of you in this moment, as you walk away from this couch. Forget the marriage, forget the sex, right? You were a team. You had each other's back. So the question is the friendship more important or is the ego more important? Polly?
Friendship.
Adam?
Friendship, yeah.
All right, so I think you two have something to say to each other.
Sorry.
How sorry?
I don't, oh, fuck off. I don't want to be in this position with you.
Yeah, I'm sorry for things that I've said and done that's hurt you. It was never my intention.
I hope that we can obviously just move forward from this and just be friends and be civil and amicable and hopefully still continue what I've learned in future relationships. Mm. And I'm just thankful for all of you for being there throughout it.
We love you both so much.
Thank you for your honesty. Thank you for your willing to see hurdles and still fight through them. You know, I think a lot of people are going to learn so much from the two of you. I know that we have. So thank you. Thank you so much.
Well done, you guys.
I do really hope that Adam and I can move forward with how we left things on the couch and to just keep everything in the future friendly and respectful.
Let's welcome to the couch Emma and Casper.
Jesus, here we go.
Well, hello, you two.
We're back.
There they go.
Welcome back.
Thank you.
We're the other way around most of the time, aren't we?
Do you want to go the other way?
You always had a side. I always just followed your lead.
Maybe now we're over.
Shots fired.
They're still laughing together. This is good.
Yeah, this is good.
Yeah.
So for the two of you, looking back on your relationship, what would you say have been the highlights?
There were some really good times. I've been lucky to have Emma through this process. As much as it's been a struggle, because we are very different people, it made me realise Emma deserved a husband who could give her what she was looking for, and that wasn't fair on her, and that's on me. But I'm trying to get better. I'm far more aware now of what I would be looking for in a future partner.
Great. So going through this process, you've gained some incredible insight from this that you can now take into your next relationship. Emma, how does that land for you?
I think the whole experience has really taught me. I think confidence is really, really attractive. I need someone who makes me laugh. And I always vowed that I need someone to put me in my place, but I do need someone to put me in my place every now and again. You know, fit as well.
Thanks, Emma.
No.
Have either of you been out there in the dating world?
I mean, I think both of us have gone on some dates, right?
No, I haven't had a man of the month.
Can I give one little bit of advice?
Yeah.
Don't label them the month of the year you're going to be dating them. Like, give them at least a six-month period.
Mr. February can easily become Mr. March.
So there's scope.
Oh, yeah.
There's scope
there. That's good. The dream.
So is it fair to say that we have a nice friendship here now?
I think so. Yeah. We've got a lot of history together now, and then, yeah.
Yes, and I've got to say, I know it's been hard, and I know there's been pain along the way, but I can see that you're both extracting the lessons already, you know, and I know that you're both just going to fly in your next relationships. I can't wait to see that for the two of you.
Yeah, thank you for being that, you know, because it could have been a lot worse, but I managed to learn a lot about me. Just thank you for being my wife.
Beautiful.
I think for me, I would never like wish for someone else to be there at the end of the aisle. I think we had our own beautiful experience that we'll share for the rest of our lives. And yeah, hopefully we'll both get married again and that'll be lovely. I expect an invite, you know?
You saying I'm gonna get married first?
Oh, maybe, yeah.
I love that.
Woo! Guys, thank you so
thank
much.
Thank you so thank much, you both of you. Thank you.
Oh, love you guys.
All right, so, Hannah, how are you doing?
I'm okay, how are you?
You know what? I'm disappointed that Stephen's not here.
I mean, are we surprised?
Are you?
No.
Why?
You saw the reaction at the wedding, like, his reaction was incredible. And I just feel like on the honeymoon, the first hurdle, he just couldn't be asked. I just feel a little bit like there was no effort. And then I think it just got to a point where we were just flogging a dead horse. Mm-hmm. And as much as it went to absolute shit for me, I don't regret it. I'm glad I met some of the people that I met.
And this is fair, because this is your perspective. And one thing we have to acknowledge is Stephen's not here, so he can't defend himself in this. And so let's try moving forward now. We've seen it. You've had your fair share of conflict amongst the group. It's interesting because you have a lot of energy, Hannah. And I think that sometimes you intend to make it better, but sometimes you enter a room, things go left.
Yeah.
Why do you believe that is?
I just feel a little bit like I was very much misunderstood from the beginning. I think there were some things that I did do wrong, and I think my banter got took the wrong way. With this group, there was some of other people's insecurities and other people's situations that were then being put onto me. And I feel like there was a real sort of pack mentality. Like, I walked into a room on girls' night and got called a slag, and look what the cat dragged in, and I just wouldn't treat another woman like that. That was hands down one of the hardest nights of my entire life.
Can't cope someone playing victim when they're not owning their actions. It's giving weak.
In my opinion, the whole group wasn't against that. It was you and Holly hashing it out. We was leaving you two to it.
Everybody but was chipping
when
in.
When the slag comment was made, you two was on a different table. You weren't
but
even sat with us.
I walked into a room, I got looked up and down like a piece of shit, and Holly looked me dead in the eye and said, look what the cat dragged in.
I know I did.
Holly was coming for me, then Shannon was piping up, then Lacey was coming. Everyone just came for me from every angle.
I've only ever reacted to your behaviour. I don't do things out of, like, being a mean girl. I'm not a mean girl. I'm just very honest.
So you don't think how you behaved on both girls' night was mean? You don't think that was mean at all?
No, that was me responding to your actions. Because she's disrespected me so much and pecked and pecked and pecked and pecked, she deserves everything she gets.
Holly, you literally bullied and victimised me in a room.
This is the moral of the story. So, I went into yesterday's dinner party with something in my head that Hannah had said. Now, say what you want of me. Shoot bullets at me. I'm not always dodging. But talk about my children, I'm coming to war. I was being calm, and then Hannah said something like, fuck off. And I thought, you know what? You're fucking having it. I was being calm. And then Hannah said something like, fuck off. And I thought, you know what? I'm fucking having it. The fire lit. I lost my shit. I was furious.
And then it went from zero to 100. Yeah. And I have to say that I was quite disappointed because it started to become aggressive.
Yeah.
And that's not acceptable.
No, I take accountability of like my actions.
Hannah, is there anything that you would like to say?
No.
Okay.
I'm done at this point with trying to communicate with Holly. It's like banging your head against a brick wall.
Hopefully you both can reflect on your contribution to this argument.
Yeah.
And maybe think about maybe how you could have done things differently.
We're very different people. I would not disrespect a woman the way that Holly disrespected me. And I stand by that.
We'll hopefully get to a point, me and Hannah, where we can say hello to each other and not want to rip each other's head off.
OK, let's move on. Next up to the couch, we have Ryan and Shannon. Hey, guys.
Hey,
Laurie.
Hello.
How are we all? Ryan, let's start with you. How have things been after the experiment?
Obviously, the way it ended was not the way I expected, so it took a long time to get over that. Mm-hmm. I'm still not over that now.
Yeah.
Will I ever? Probably not.
Yeah. I suppose there's still some sadness there and something you need to process there. Shannon, how have you been feeling?
I probably wasn't as honest as I should have been with you guys or myself. From the beginning, I got kind of caught up in the good things that I've seen and let red flags slide that I wouldn't normally, because I really wanted it to work. He would give me these compliments and make me feel amazing. Yeah. But then 30 seconds down the line, it'd be just a holiday romance for me. And I expressed to him that I didn't like it. It wasn't funny to me. It wasn't banter.
That was just a joke. There was nothing behind that.
As soon as we were behind closed doors was when the little digs would come out, things about my weight. I was insecure. I was timid. Little comments. And it felt like Ryan was trying to keep me under his thumb so that I would come running back to him when he was giving me the compliments.
I think this is all quite new to us. Ryan, what are your thoughts about what Shannon is saying?
I did mention about her weight and that. She was put on antibiotics and I was saying, like, you're not eating properly. And I was trying to look out for her. Since being diagnosed with cancer, I think your health's very important. So if they was my intentions that it came across, I apologise for that, but that was never my intentions. I just find it hard that it's my red flags, but I'm being told who I can and can't speak to.
I never said that you couldn't speak to any of the girls in here.
Certain people here know that I couldn't speak to Hannah.
Do you think I'm going to stay with somebody that's going to flirt with somebody else?
I wasn't flirting. There would have been no flirting from me.
I seen it happen and he said, did you see Hannah stroking my foot?
But you was annoyed about what Hannah had done on the retreat.
Ryan's never flirted with me, I'm just going to put it out there. He hasn't.
You've made it out to the rest of the group that I'm this bad person.
What?
And I've sat back and I've not bit, and I'll continue not to bite.
I think what's really confusing here is that the two of you didn't bring some of these concerns to the couch, and the two of you have literally just walked away. Do you feel that there's a tendency in both of you to run away at maybe the first sign of trouble?
I think I do the opposite. I hang on for too long, and it was this time I realised I'm not hanging on. And it got to the point, it was the most ridiculous argument. We started arguing over shoelaces. He told me all his feelings were fake. He never meant any of it. And I thought, I've done it too many times and I'm not doing it again.
So over a pathetic argument over a pair of shoes made you leave an experiment?
But it was a multitude of things that added up.
I mean, it sounds like quite an abrupt end, because there was clearly a real attraction between the two of you. But some of these little niggling misunderstandings weren't brought here so that we could work through them. Whilst you've both got this opportunity today, is there anything you'd like to say to one another? Ryan, can we start?
Absolutely nothing.
There's nothing you'd like to add?
Nothing.
I think that says a lot.
And Shannon, there's nothing that you'd like to add?
I am sorry for not being completely honest. I probably, on reflection, should have been more open with Ryan the day that I decided to leave.
Well, it's been a real pleasure meeting the two of you, and I really wish you all the best with relationships moving forward.
Thank you.
Lovely to meet you.
Thank you. Thanks.
Thank you, guys. Thank you.
Let's welcome to the couch Ross and Sasha.
You're always so far behind me. It takes ages.
Welcome back, you two.
Hello.
How have things been since we last saw you?
Things have been really good. Like, after we left the experiment, Ross moved straight to Warsaw.
Wow.
It was a bit rocky at first. And, like, we'd get into arguments and it'd be like, boom, straight to Manchester, gone. But we've kind of found, like, balance now and we're in a really good place.
Ross, how have you been navigating seeing your daughter?
You've been seeing her on weekends, haven't you, still?
Yeah, I love every weekend, though. Mm-hmm. I'm going to go up to Wallace Dyer at some point as well.
And how's it been living with Sasha?
Oh! That's actually good, you know, that. I love it.
Well, why don't we take a look at the journey that the two of you have had so far.
I can't believe I'm getting married today.
I do want to find that amazing relationship with someone.
Hello.
Hello.
You're
okay? You're right. He's tall, covered in tattoos, and I can communicate a little bit in sign, so maybe it was meant to be. Ross goes above and beyond for me. He literally can't do more. Oh, you're so cute.
I know. That's where I am.
I've got all this love. It's just quite overwhelming.
I will protect her.
Yeah.
I will cop her. And I will respect her.
You know, you got my blessing, right?
Oh, I love that, man. Love that, man.
I have no doubt that he feels love.
I say it out loud if I have to. But, yeah.
Say it out loud. Oh. Say it on your door.
I love you.
Me and Ross got into an argument. He spent the night in a separate apartment. I don't know how we're going to go forward.
If they want to come to an argument, we don't want to stop.
I did right leave.
Ross, how do you feel about Sasha?
I just want to make this where I know we can, and I'm going to fight for it, and I'm going to bring them back up here again so they can get the smile back in the face again. I was blown away by our connection straight away, and I knew you were the one for me. I'm going to move towards though to be with you.
I can't wait to start our lives together. I love you, Ross, always.
How does it feel?
Don't know, it just brings a lot of emotions. Watching it puts it into perspective of how much love we've got for each other. It was nice seeing him with my dad as well. Yeah, that got me like, quite emotional because I hadn't seen that.
One of the things we saw a glimpse of there is you guys struggling with emotional regulation.
Mm-hmm.
Things go from 0 to 10 pretty quickly. So can you tell us a bit about how the conflict has been happening since you left the experiment?
I think it always starts off as something like really small and then it just ends up escalating. Sometimes I feel like I'm communicating it to Ross and it can be quite passive aggressive and then that irritates me and then it just gets to this till it's like, bruh! Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And then we're like, oh shit, is this healthy? Is this all right?
Have you guys ever tried any time out when things are getting a bit heated?
Oh, well, when we left, Ross's favourite thing to do was 5 minutes. I want 5 minutes, 5 minutes. At first, it kind of felt like he was doing it to take control of the situation. It was almost like a threat. It felt like, I'm going to close my eyes and not listen to you unless you give me 5 minutes. But not in, like, a calm way. It was like, I said 5 minutes, 5 minutes. It just winds me up.
I'd be like, obviously, I can't,
You all find it funny, but it's the most aggravating thing. Yeah. It just completely takes all...
It takes your control away.
Yeah.
And I guess for you, Ross, with Sasha describing some of your communication there as passive-aggressive, that's sometimes what happens when you're not expressing how you really feel.
I hold it in, yeah. Well, it shouldn't really, because I need to pull it out and talk and communicate more, yeah.
Yeah. It's really important that it is in a loving way. Mm-hmm. You know, it's not used as a punishment. It's not shutting each other out. It's both coming together and saying, OK, I can feel this getting a bit heated. Let's both agree on maybe it's 30 minutes, maybe it's a bit more than just the five.
We'll work on it. We'll work on it.
You've got to work on it, absolutely. And this is one of the joys of being in a relationship is conflict is inevitable. In fact, it's important, you know, that you're able to work through it and heal from it.
No problem, yeah. I would do that.
Wonderful stuff, you guys. So what does the future hold for the two of you?
I always said if we're in a really good place, I'd be more than happy to move to Manchester so Ross can be Boy's daughter. Yeah. I just need to know we're going to be good. We've got something really special.
We do.
Yeah.
Oh, I love that.
Certainly watching you look like a united team, absolutely connected. The two of you have been working at this. You haven't been cruising, you've been listening, you've been taking on the feedback and you've been giving it a go. That's just beautiful to watch. It's a testament to both of you.
Yeah, I just think we've been really lucky to find each other through this.
Well, look, thank you so much for trusting us, for listening to us. We are so pleased to see where you've arrived. The love that is brimming over the surface here. Thank you so much.
Okay, if I could have Christina and Karen come on back.
Hello, you two.
Hi, guys.
Hello.
Okay. Hello. It is great for us to see you both. Now, last night brought up some confronting issues, but let's begin with your married at first sight journey.
This needs to work. I don't want to be single for the rest of my life.
I deserve unconditional love. I'm not settling for any less.
Oh, my God.
You OK? What's your name? Oh, you look pet.
I think Kieran is hilarious.
You want my woman?
I'm feeling like I've just hit gold.
Hey, 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 hey.
Christina is the brightest coloured pencil in the pencil case. She just lights up every room that she walks into.
We are building such good foundations. I am falling for Kieran.
Do you want me to say it?
Yeah, you see it.
Oh, OK. Yes, we have been intimate.
Oh, God, sorry, Mum.
I am so open with my emotions and I can't hide it. Am I too much for you? PMDD hit. It just feels really just dark and horrible, and I just don't want it to push you away. We haven't got that intimate connection at the moment, and I am just feeling rejected.
I'm really questioning at the minute if I'm able to sustain a relationship with someone that suffers with PMDD.
This is why I prepare myself for the worst. Well, it's fucking shit.
The more I'm realising we're a little bit different in pretty important areas of my life.
You put a husband at the top of the list of your priorities, whereas I'll never give me whole self to someone ever again. Like, I'll always
put my major needs first.
You and my ex-partner, it's actually scary how similar you are.
I'm not his ex.
There's way more goods than there is bads, but the bads are very heavily weighted.
You could see yourself spending the rest of your life with him.
Yeah, I do really like him.
We love each other as people, but the dots just aren't connecting at the moment.
I'm potentially risking losing one of the best women that I could ever wish for. And that's one of the hardest things to admit to myself.
You're bringing people smiles everywhere you go. And I was sitting grinning because I was like, this is my wife.
But if I can't see things moving forward, I'm not going to lead you on. Because I do care about you, but at the minute, it feels like more of a friendship than anything else. And I never came in here to hurt anyone.
I just don't want to see you lose someone who is phenomenal for you.
I just don't know how much I've got left in us for the amount of emotional support Christina needs.
I won't leave.
Gonna leave.
So that was, that hit everyone, right?
Are you okay?
Looking at that, walk us through, Christina.
I could see a future with Kieran. I thought, yeah, that like, this is it. I've got a real husband. But, you know, when obviously the cracks started to show, you can just see in our faces, like when we were crying, like you can see how much like it meant to us.
Kieran, how are you feeling seeing that?
Shit. Me and Steena both came into this for the right reasons. And it hasn't worked, which is really sad. And I'm forever sorry that it hasn't worked.
Okay.
I never meant to hurt you.
No.
Let's look at the dinner party, okay? You know, Kieran, you definitely seemed shocked at Christina's approach, should I say, to you, and some of the things that she had mentioned. Is that the case?
Yeah.
I think because I have really struggled being home, to not just be able to feel like I can just pick up the phone and talk to Kieran just for a bit of reassurance and support, that was really hard, and it was like hard to wrap my brain around it. So yeah, at the dinner party, as soon as I saw Kieran, crumbled. Literally, yeah, I crumbled. My emotions just got the better of me.
You know, what definitely seemed to have an impact as well is Kieran had mentioned that he's been dating someone.
Yeah.
So how did you take that?
Yeah, not well. Hearing that just be so casually, yeah, I've been dating someone. It made me wonder, like, how much did it mean to Kieran? Because it meant the absolute fucking world to me.
So far, that was the best, I would say, 4 weeks of my life were with you. Mm. And that's never going to change. No one's going to take that away from me. Mm. And I'm really, really pleased that it was you at the end of the aisle. I can't get words out of my head sometimes. But to have her sitting thinking that I don't care about her, shit.
You know, there were times in this experiment where, without question, you two were the strongest couple.
Yeah.
Why are you not together? I mean, that's what I'm trying to understand, what the real reason is.
Kieran didn't want me.
Why are you not together? I mean, that's what I'm trying to understand, what the real reason is.
Kieran didn't want me.
I would say one of the reasons is how much I think Christina relies on a partner. And I'm not saying I don't want to be a shoulder to lean on, but I've been there before, and that's a trigger. I haven't got the mental capacity to help you when you need that strength, because sometimes I haven't even got it for myself. It's difficult to console you as your ex-husband when you're feeling the way you're feeling. That's why I sit and get emotional.
What do we do right now? The first thing that I think we could do is, between the two of you, you could set the boundaries of what does it mean to be a friend. His detaching isn't because he didn't care about you or he didn't care about the relationship, is that this is how he is built. This is what the relationships that he's been in has taught him, that he must rely on himself. What are you thinking about right now?
I'm just, I've never been able to explain that before. So for you to explain that to Christina means a lot.
When you have those boundaries in place, what's beautiful is that the boundaries loosen up. Without question, you two want to be each other's friends.
Yeah.
I do. Just because I can't reply to you every bloody minute of the day doesn't mean I'm not your mate.
You know, if you're not able to be in touch every single day, would it help if the two of you arranged to meet up so you've got something to look forward to?
So, actually, before I came in here, I booked a festival and I actually bought two tickets because I thought I was going to have a husband to obviously take. So, do you want to come?
I've never been to a festival. I'd love to come.
I like that. Yeah, you love it.
All right, I love it. Christina, Kieran, that concludes your journey.
Thank you
on Married at First Sight. So thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Mine and Kira's chapter, it has ended now, but it doesn't mean our story has finished.
Well, that concludes not just our time together today, but the experiment as a whole. We hope that you've all learned valuable lessons, regardless of whether you're leaving us today with a husband or a wife or friends for life. And we wish each and every one of you all the very best for the future.
Yeah!
Thank you so much.
Of course, I wish that things did turn out differently, but I have made a genuinely beautiful, beautiful soul who is now one of my friends for life.
Everyone wants that fairy tale wedding and that dream, and I feel like it's come true.
I do have many regrets. The fact that I made Amy upset is what makes me sad. It's just a shame it didn't work.
Hi, darling.
I try my absolute best in every situation, and I stay true to myself, and I'm proud of myself.
I love you.
It's crazy that it all turned out as a hoax.
I love you so much.
I love you more.
To apply for future series of Married at First Sight, go to channel4.com/takepart.